Yeah, MuZone was invented in 2005, and the idea was to bring together from all over Europe musicians and music business students to, on one hand, work together for 1 week, have a final concerts with compositions, arrangements, lyrics, and show they could do on the last night. Beside that, we had that business game from the very first day on, where they do kind of a case study on how company and agency functions and to get into competition with each other. The basic principle was that we got some EU funds out of that, and that's how we started. It was a Leonardo project. So we brought together up to 8 countries from Europe and added on later to around people from the US, Columbia College, and also in between some people from China. This is a very open concept, actually. And what we think the spin-off could be that students, musicians, and music business students get to know each other very well through this working week, and that they work together maybe later on.
Let me tell you a little bit about the game. I know that some people have been told little bits of information. It's always, it excites me when people don't really know too much about what's going to happen. Just to sort of tell you a little bit about it. So as Mariana says, this is the 9th year, so you are the 9th set of game players, which is really cool. And so you should be really, we're very proud of the fact that you're the 9th, and you should be proud of the fact that you're here as well, although I'm not sure how you're going to feel at the end of the week. You may feel very different about it.
Hey, my name is Kianda Hodgi. I'm from the University of Westminster, where I'm the program director for the BA Honours Commercial Music Program. But I'm also an entertainment lawyer. My role is the coordinator of the business game, and I've been such, I think, for the last 9 years. So that's what I do here, and I kind of help to sort of keep things on track with the control room upstairs. I think the course or this activity benefits students in a number of ways, and primarily the way is that it develops their sort of understanding of themselves and their role within the music industry. What their potential role might be also within the music industry, how they might be able to function as an active participant on various different levels. So it helps them to be able to put into context some of the theoretical learning that they might have had in their institutions and allow them a sort of platform to be able to put some of that into some practical activity. In other words, understand the not only the breadth, the theoretical breadth, but also the practical depth of what they've learned about things. And so it's a little bit like a simulation. It's a place, a lab, a laboratory, if you like, where they can come and they can experiment with various different ideas, business ideas, new ventures, that kind of thing. And the beautiful thing about doing it here in this environment, of course, is that you don't lose any money if things go badly, if things go wrong. But you also learn valuable lessons about what works and what doesn't work. And other things that they learn include things like, for example, leadership. It's really interesting how some of the people who adopt positions of leadership within the teams really find themselves. They really do find a real strength in themselves to become, you know, real good leaders. And so I think, you know, they're operating under pressure. They're in situations where they have to inspire their teams to do things, you know, to come up with new ideas, to keep constantly working. And that's a great skill for them to learn, that they actually can lead, you know, groups of people. And I think the students that we've had go through the program through the last sort of 8-9 years have proven that, you know, they've gone on to do really great things as leaders in their fields.
Welcome, everybody. Well, on behalf of the Pop Academy of Udo Dahn and on behalf of the Bayerische Musikakademie Hammelburg, I would like to welcome you all here for the 9th edition of the European Band and Business Camp. And we start the singer-songwriter presentation.
Mach mir ein leckeres Süppchen und streich's in den Weg.
Well, the business game has developed over the years, and because we've got a really great team of business coaches that have come every year, we all kind of know each other really well. You know, we know what each other's strengths and weaknesses are, and the control room's full of really wonderful people without which the game could never have worked as well as it has. How it works does rely on that expertise that sits in that room upstairs. Basically, the idea is that we try and contain 3 years of activity within 3 days. So we try and replicate activity within the music industry within that time. We do this by condensing time. And the way we look at the calculation of time is that every 2 hours equals 1 month of trading in the real world. And what we try and do is, as much as possible, is to provide the students with a real life experience of that. So one of the key things that anybody has to do in the music industry still to this day, despite the changes that have occurred, is to acquire talent. Because the whole industry works on, you know, turning around talent, finding really talented people, and then, you know, monetizing that. So what we do is we have here in Hammelburg on campus a number of different ensembles, bands, if you will. So they constitute the talent that the record companies, as business units, have to sign at some point.
They don't seem to be here.
No money. Let's go.
Hi. Oh, hi, welcome. I'm Jeff. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Hello.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Do you have any artists signed?
No, not yet. But we've taken interest in especially one artist, Oliver.
Yes, we already had a first meeting with Oliver's manager, and we will be at the showcase tonight and discuss more options.
Yeah, okay. But he knows, the artist manager, and Oliver knows that we are very interested in working with him. But yeah,
so like that's all for next year then, right?
Yeah, this year, that's coming.
Yeah, 2014. You can need an artist to record it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The showcase is in May, or June,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
This is going to complete next year, so that's how we want to have the full year next year.
So it means we won't make any money back this year?
Hopefully we will.
But we want to invest now,
yeah.
And then in the future next year, we'll get that back by having this.
Yeah, I mean, especially, you know, you're a pretty big company as well, like 5 people.
Yeah.
Well, our plan is first to get some audience, like following people in the first year, and so we have to invest a lot. But then the next year, we also want to start merch, and so get an income, and also then with the records, of course, because then we have the audience, and then we get the income.
Mm-hmm. The music that you hear, the music that you heard when you came in here, it was Oliver's band. Was his EP. So,
I liked it.
Yeah,
yeah,
we liked it also, and we believe that it's the future.
Could be big as well.
Yeah.
And that's shit I hear on radio the long day.
So, let me ask you, what happens if Keogh and Oliver don't fall to your child?
Well, we have several other artists that we're interested in, but this is our top priorities, and we hope that they will work with the best company of 2014, the Gazelle Castle of the Kingside.
Yes,
we have another
yes.
Project, so.
Thank you very much for coming.
When can you?
You know, up to 14 bands in the rock school, which means they rehearse every day. The main goal is to compose throughout the week, to write lyrics, arrange those, and setting up a showcase that they can play in the end of the week in a final concert. We'll be right back.
to go from the 9/8 again and see if we can get the last part to the end. When it comes in way too slow, actually, and not for me, but you think, wow, it's like so fat, and so we can celebrate that part. Yeah, great, the song is in the arrangement is in the pocket, now the whole thing. Or should we have a small break? I feel like a break.
Oh, it's a back catalogue, all the songs of ABBA is for sale.
Okay.
Because I'm retiring from my
own. He owns the rights
of all the
ABBA records.
Yeah.
He wants to sell them.
Okay.
If the label buys them, the label owns the whole back catalogue and can sell ABBA.
I got it. Okay, thank you.
So, please make your offers now. I schedule. As I said, I bought a house in Monte Carlo, so I have to go by plane then.
Excuse me, so the plane is waiting as well?
Oh, it's waiting, yeah.
Yeah, the feeling.
You have a car?
The pilot's just rung.
Yeah, so did you order a car for me?
Yeah, I'll get it. Yeah, so
Thank you.
Thank you.
He's conducting some business right here, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I don't think it's anything for our company.
What? I respect
thanks
that.
For the invite.
I respect that.
No, thanks. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Take care.
What was interesting though is how they tried to, how some of them tried to make each other think that they'd submitted a bid.
Yeah.
Because rather like unsophisticated, like the last two who walked out without saying it's not really for us.
Yeah.
So they didn't put in a bid. So everybody knows they didn't put in a bid. Those that witnessed that. The other two put in a bid, put in a piece of paper.
Yeah.
But it didn't want to fit, so everybody write that.
It's
very smart.
Can
we very, very smart.
Can
very
we write
smart
into Facebook or Twitter, like rumors that...
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We've got the rumors.
Rumors that Digitaurus Rex are buying the back catalogue of Apple. Like
it's not true.
It's not true. That's
yes. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, awesome.
Because then, like... They awesome. Think, oh fuck, like we should have bet more.
Yeah.
So, like, we didn't bet at all. And the restaurant said, oh damn, like should we have bet?
Oh yeah, yeah, that's good. That's good.
Yeah. Okay, like, meanwhile, one of them is going, I didn't do anything. I promised
oh, yeah.
I didn't do anything.
Like, within the team, like, hey, I swear, I didn't have anything.
That's
like,
your promise.
Did you really?
From
oh yeah.
That sets up a whole dynamic, man. Oh, that's the arguing. Are you sure you didn't bid?
Yeah, did you write the name of the company on the sheet?
Yes!
You know,
next thing we discover, she wants to leave the company.
Yeah. She's fired.
Well, she's fired.
So, yeah, enjoy this evening, and I'd like to welcome the first band, Laura.
Thank you. Yeah, it's hard to say at the moment because you know, it's so intense. Yeah, like your brain is just like constantly focused on new things. So yeah, I would assume that I am learning a lot. But I would probably notice like when I get home after a few weeks, like, oh, yeah. I've been very fortunate with my group. We're working very good together. Like we have a good communication. Maybe the structure within the group could be a little bit better, but we're still like, we're working it out. So yeah, we've been very fortunate with our co-workers.
A bit late on that though.
Yeah. Oh my god, is this your label? Is this. Hello, love, alright, hello, take a seat. One person,
Yes, one person.
For a press conference, have you alright? This is going to be interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
You know what it's about? Present, you know what I mean?
What is this about?
Tell us.
Maybe you need to go
label.
Oh, they're gonna
get.
Oh, this is serious.
It's gonna be a big one, mate. Trust me, it's gonna take over the front page. Hold that front page for me. This is serious. No, mate. I'll owe you a beer after this. Definitely. It looks like a big one.
Good
afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this press conference that we put together to discuss the issues. There was recent rumours about Keane's involvement in his recording of his album, where he had been accused of using an unauthorised sample from the well-known group from Sweden called ABBA.
Yeah, we read that.
Yeah, we read that.
I consulted with the label, and I did inform them, though I personally wasn't in attendance at the recording session due to other commitments. Keane did do an interview there recently where he was really unaware of the situation, and he admitted two journalists in America that he had in fact used a sample of ABBA on his recording.
Okay, go on.
Hold on. I think it's time for you to say what you feel happened on the day.
Well, when I started deciding to do with the album, there was this one song and it was stuck in my head and it kind of influenced it a bit, but I couldn't get the right message across or the right sound. So after listening to, I had ABBA on my iPhone, I was listening to it, and I just got this idea in my head. I'd be like, oh, this would be really cool just to take a tiny bit of this song and put it in just to see what would happen, and it just happened to work. And I wasn't aware of the consequences, and I thought it would be a good homage to do it, to kind of push it to what I wanted it to be, and obviously it kind of backfired, but yeah. I didn't mean to do it intentionally.
Due to communication problems, he couldn't, he didn't realise his significance, so he didn't explain to me that he had in fact used a sample without permission. He didn't realise that he actually needed permission because he thought it was a homage. Mm-hmm. And so all we can do is really apologise, and you know, hopefully we can try and sort it out. But
well,
yeah, we just didn't realise.
It's like the label's in trouble here, mate. Well, hey. So, you got any comment? Anybody on the label? Who's the label? Anyone comment here, please?
Is he from the label?
Are you from the label over there, mate?
Yeah, I'm from the label.
Can you introduce yourself?
I mean, you've released material that's like infringing material. What have you got to say?
First statement, please.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't say that much at this moment because I have to talk about this with our artists, and we have to check and we will solve it. And I'm sure we will find any solution.
Yeah, what the fuck? Do you want to talk with the artist?
Yeah, we have to talk with the publisher of the album.
We're going to print a story.
Copyrighting.
So, what are you saying exactly? Are you going to defend Keane? How are you going to play this?
We're going to just negotiate it.
Negotiate with who?
With the publisher of
who's the publisher?
It's, of ABBA, it's Castle of Kings. So,
really interesting interview with them. It's going to be big.
Yeah, we're going to interview them later. So, anybody else got anything to say? Come on, we need to print something. No.
We're going to try to sort this out with the rights owners, and
just try to solve this in a friendly way, because obviously it's a misunderstanding somewhere in the process. It's not on purpose, and it's a sad story that it happened. We'll try to solve it in a good way that's suitable for all parts involved.
From our point of view, what Keane was actually really doing was highlighting the fact that ABBA were a hugely important band, and he felt that they could benefit from utilisation of their music would bring their music to his audience as well. So, you know, I thought it was a good, innocent move, but an honest and a lot of integrity involved in
what
that.
What was the song?
What was the song?
It's actually called Money, Money, Money.
Ah, yeah, somebody's going to be losing a lot of money.
You
money,
know,
money.
Pass.
You going to drop him? Come on.
You're not
going to drop him, or are you going to
support him? We support our artists.
You support your artists in copyright infringement. Is that what you do?
Well, let's.
You support copyright. You support sampling.
Both. Well, like I say, I'm sorry, and hopefully the consequences won't be.
Fucking
too severe.
Liars.
No, we're happy with the label. They might be happy with us at the moment, but I'm sure we could, you know, we can come up with a strategy.
Any more comment from the label at all?
No. Well, since not to say too much, but we can also see this as an opportunity for maybe both sides. If it's a good song,
absolutely.
ABBA could be beneficial from it as well as we could.
Okay.
Mm.
Okay, so label supports their artists in copyright infringement. Ripping off. Good story.
Yeah.
Front page.
Well, of course, the favorite part is when you manage to solve a problem when it actually works out in the end. Because there's always like, but then there's always a new thing coming up straight after that. So, just the process of solving problems and when it actually works, that would be my favorite parts, I guess. What happened was we saw a rumor on Twitter page, and it was about one of our artists making a copyright infringement on a song from another company here. So there was going to be a lawsuit, and journalists came knocking on our door and just dragged us to the press conference, and we weren't prepared for this, so we were just... Yeah, it was a weird situation, but then that's what you learn, because all of these scenarios that are created, it's actually real emotions connected to them. So it's...
Kingside,
the
best record company I know.
A lot of ways, it benefits us in a lot of ways. Any experience that musicians have in working together and collaborating together and creating new music is just another brick in the wall as far as building your tool belt and your background. Obviously, the international component of it is, particularly for American kids, it's unique because, you know, we don't have that much as much interaction as Europeans with people from other countries. And so it's often a pretty eye-opening, positive thing to realize that there are all these other people out there that are rocking too, you know, so it opens up a lot of possibilities. People tend to make, in many cases, they make lasting friendships or collaborative partnerships just in this one single week, so it has a lot of value to it.
Almost. Right down needs to come right down.
Yeah.
Everyone charge into it. Get the whole thing going, right? Take it.
down and build on it, and the ending. Just take it from the breakdown thing. Just get that right, and then the ending. Right?
Yeah, the chorus, and then the breakdown.
Chorus,
so
breakdown,
after the rap.
And then do the outro right from there down, and then come out.
Break was too early, right?
No, it happened, but everyone was still kept at the same volume. Just woof, put the brakes on and the volume and stuff.
Yeah.
Take it down, right, and then just build it as you go through it, yeah?
The last break.
No, it's not too early. It didn't.
Oh, the finale, the end.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Do you want to try that end bit? One more. Do it before you do it. Just try the end bit.
Let's start the chorus after the rap,
okay.
And then the breakdown, and then the end.
Okay.
Yeah?
Good. Just try and remember that breakdown. It goes right down, right? Yeah?
And we got to record that, right?
Yeah.
All right.
You recorded that time?
Yeah.
Great. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay. That's done.
Well, shall we do them all three?
We do all three.
Okay, shall we do them all three? Start with...
Just a little wrap. Okay, we've got three at the moment, right? Just think about it. We won't do it now. Just think about the fact of like the running order, what way this is going to pan out, what way you're going to start off and what way you're going to finish. It is a set. There's only maybe three or four numbers in it, but you got to look at where you're going to start with and then. Don't worry about it now, but just think about it. That's something we got to decide on, yeah? What number are you going to do first? The middle one, the last one, or whatever, that kind of thing. But start off the way we rehearse anyway. Do you want to start off with the...
The jazzy one.
Yeah, the first one, your first one. Then go into the rock one. Do it the way we rehearsed at the moment. Yeah. Okay.
How are you guys doing? Welcome to this Maximize Showcase event.
How the students adapt to that sort of condensed time frame in order to be able to get things done. So we will, for example, set them down one of three things. We'll send them down some good news. It might be that they've won a bid for something. It could be a dilemma, which means that it's something that they have to make a decision about. Do they sign this artist, or do they set up a new area of business? And we set up these kind of dilemmas so that there's always consequences, one way or another. And then there's the third thing, which is the bad news. So for example, if things don't go well, or they hand in a really bad marketing strategy for an artist that they've signed, then they will get bad sales figures. And that could be bad news. Or an artist dies, or something like that happens. Those kind of things do occur. So we create scenarios, effectively, that replicate, that we try and do. And the key to it all is that us in the control room as business coaches can be anything at any time. We can be a bunch of shareholders that insist that the company do something. We can be pressmen at some point. We could be Universal 1 minute, or we could be Sony, or we could be a major. Just in order to be able to play out these roles to help sort of bring a sense of reality to the student experience, and hopefully that helps them learn.
We'd just like to thank you for coming. Good to see you again.
Yes.
Us here at White Wall Records, we believe we've continued to strive in the manic music industry. Since our formation in early January of 2014, we believe we've gone from strength to strength. We boast a very talented and diverse roster of artists. We've just signed Oliver Simmons, we're delighted to announce.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know if he's heard of him. He's a very up-and-coming great artist. Rising rock star, Luke de Jong, our publisher, our publishing business.
Is everything okay with Luke? Because I heard
something. So far, so good.
What happened there?
Sorry?
There was
an incident where he was allegedly dissing the brand he was endorsed by. Whether it's true or not, we're not too sure, but things seem to be.
Doesn't matter once it's in the media, isn't it?
It's in the media.
Yeah.
But is he okay?
We take this very serious. We really do. So we're going to talk to our sponsors, the brands, the Jack Daniels, and talk this through with them. So we're going to have a meeting with them. We're going to keep in touch with them and just fix the meeting.
Maximize Records, because they are the record label of Andy, and as you know, we've got the publishing contract with Andy, so we earned another $15,000 by publishing Andy's.
Calm down. For Christ's sake.
I want it.
Oh, this is not very good.
No.
Right. I think we might postpone our meeting, like.
Now let me get him out. I'll get him out.
We thought you said he was alright. You
shouldn't talk to
him
for a
second. It's pretty obvious he's not alright.
What's this?
This wasn't good at all.
Well.
That we.
We didn't really expect that, to be honest, because we thought he would like.
We didn't expect that because you guys told us everything is fine, it's just a rumor.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, this is not a rumor.
Well, let's say it's gonna be fine. We'll take care about that. We'll make sure they get a proper treatment for his addiction.
You know, this might hurt us. This might hurt us.
Of course, it might hurt us.
Yeah,
we need to consult. The thing is, it's a very harmful situation.
Yeah.
Fair enough. We can completely understand your worries now, but we assure you we take care of that. We will.
Hence the reason why we asked the question about your association, continued association with alcohol.
Well, we might have to look at that and change our views on the alcohol association now.
Probably, yeah. We'll
figure
that out.
Let's hope the press doesn't get hold of this, shall we?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. It's just happy to get to
the press, bitch.
Yeah, yeah. They can be all over the place.
Cheers.
Once it's out there, reputation. Okay. Well, I think we need to.
Yeah.
If there's anything else, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Talk to somebody before you throw away that heart and that walk.
Him.
Yeah. Yo, brother.
Him.
Put your hands on me. No, relax, sit down over here now. Calm down.
Unbelievable.
Ha 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 ha.
I think it is a, if you're really planning on working in the music industry, I think it's a really good experience because it shows you a lot of aspects that you probably didn't think of because you're doing so much in such a short time. So normally if you have some problems, you would probably only see them if you have worked out a fully project and it's gonna get you like a few months, and then another project a few months, or maybe you're gonna see some problems that normally it's gonna take you a few years. So yeah, I think you're actually having a really good experience in learning things you can actually use.
We're cool.
Why wouldn't
they want us?
The rules have changed. The 5-minute presentations will be done in front of each other. And anybody in the room will be able to ask any questions or contest what's being said by any of the people presenting. Okay? You have 5 minutes.
Okay, so Digitors Rex is all about bringing new interesting acts to the market. Our mission and vision is like to have a healthy and growing relationships with our artists. We pick them up from the beginning and turn into something really good together with them. We're very focused on relationships with the artists and the managers, and that's been very successful so far. That's what we think, that we could really do great things with the roster of Universal. However, we are really happy with our business model. We like the idea of being really small and growing with our own, on our own basis, like our own values, which is why we are not interested in being the sub-label of Universal.
5 million euros a year.
Yeah.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
And then
sit down.
Thank you.
We're White Walls Records, as you hopefully know that, and we are a young, hardworking music group that has every intention of succeeding in the music industry. So every artist we work with has received an endorsement by a big name band.
Anybody want to say anything?
Can I ask, has all the endorsements worked for you?
Yeah, they've all worked so far.
Okay, because we heard a bit of a bad reputation coming from the Jack Daniels.
Well, that's a long time ago. That was last year with Luke de Jong. It's all fixed now, so hold up. Shouldn't be a problem anymore.
Okay.
5 minutes
is over then.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
My company is Maximize. We're all about maximizing ourselves and our artists. So I think we want to maximize ourselves and not be maximized by someone by just giving some money and getting a certain career, our own career into the music industry. And I'm not really thinking that like Universal is already big enough, and even if that's maybe too far, maybe one day we can maximize ourselves at the level of Universal. So we will see.
So you say you want to compete with us?
I don't know if we can already we can't already compete with you guys, and maybe we can never compete, but we will never like team up with you guys.
So you're not bidding for it?
No.
Okay, you haven't bidding for us.
Sit down.
Hey everybody. King Records.
As it stands, we are the only major label in the Hammelburg company, or within the Hammelburg companies. And with this, we have the largest roster and the potentially largest income. And in this, makes us a more attractive company to potential managers and artists who work with us.
One more question.
So, the two separate labels you had before, when did they merge together?
They merged together.
June 2016. Okay, so June. So this is about half a year ago.
Yeah.
So do you think these were two completely different companies, they merged together, and do you think you could work together good
enough? We're working together so far, we're a perfect company at the moment, we have a strong workforce.
We're pitching ourselves as King and Queen Records now. What was in the past is in the past, and that shouldn't really brought us to attention now because we are a new company, we started from scratch, and this is what we're pitching from.
And even as separate companies, we were both very successful. Okay, That's the end.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much. And what we'll do now is we will consider the pitches that you've made and the things that you've said. We'll also consider the comments. Bear in mind that we don't have to choose somebody, so the idea is that we will let you know. There'll be an announcement, possibly at lunch, that will determine who has won the bid or whether or not the bid has actually, in fact, been won. Okay?
Thanks very much.
I think it's similar to what we do at home, but it's on a bigger level, and it's more accelerated. So, you know, in the real world situation, you're not writing like 3 or 4 songs in a day, you know? So it's a much faster pace here. And we're working with extremely talented people from all over the world, which is amazing. And they're all bringing their different styles and vibes and talent levels, and you're just expected to make it work. So in that respect, I think it teaches students how to collaborate with each other. Because in some situations, you don't necessarily, you're not in a situation where it would be someone that you would normally work with. So in that respect, you're actually taught, you know, how to collaborate, which is great.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the finale of the Memento Mori Tour, presented by Digitors Records. We're happy to have you here tonight. This tour is in memorial of our beloved and perished Yasin, as you might have heard. He tragically passed away in a car accident. Let me present to you the features.
Yeah. How's it going, everybody? Obviously, tragic circumstances recently, and I just want to lead everybody in a moment of silence in memory of Yasin.
Of 7 roses slowly withered in my hand, and the smell of burning rubber slowly drifted through the air. I rested by the side of bloodstained ribbons from the air.
Business game, I think, is the game sort of rolls out and it begins to intensify. And then the students that embrace the game, the management students that embrace the game, all of a sudden they really begin to become effective. And obviously they're learning by their mistakes within the sort of 3 days. So it's really all about the students and what they get from the experience for me. You know, so really, quite often, the best bit of the game is when they actually get home and realise what they've actually achieved in 3 days. So quite often it's the residual feelings that they have after when they realise, you know, how did I even cope with all of that.
For wonder, and then we can go for a sleep and then prepare for
It says here, treat till 4:30, we have off. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Because I like to go down as well.
Should we do a little team building before lunch?
Want to do a little group work?
End of the year.
No
so we're like
singing King Kong. Universal! King and Queens!
King and Queen?
Yeah!
Okay.
We should start the presentation by singing our own company song.
Yeah,
Dancing Queen! We started off with
Dancing
Queen. I'll play the piano.
Because we started with the ABBA catalogue,
yeah,
so that would be funny. Yeah. We should
print the lyrics in the presentation.
Dancing and King Queen!
Young and free, only 17.
2007.
Only 3 days old. No, I think we did good. Yay.
For the night
10 minutes, and then the game is
finished. Then it's lunch.
It is. Is he sleeping as well?
No.
And after
I think
what he's going to do, most busy in shower now.
Or
is he?
No.
What's the crack?
Anyway.
Would I be right in saying right now that you're in a minus deficit?
No.
Or you don't have to tell me?
No.
Alright, that's okay.
Okay?
Yep.
Alright. Yep. He said.
Dodgy dealings.
I know what that was good. And he said, will I be right in saying you don't have to tell me? Are you in the minus deficit? I said no. Obviously, they were going to try and buy in or something.
We'll just have to wait another 9 minutes.
He has to get pitched to us in 9 minutes.
No.
And now the results are in. I'm very happy to announce that the winner of the bid and the sub-label for Universal Music Group, drum roll, is King and Queen.
Yeah!
Lastly, the official announcement, the game is over.
It's over for another year.
That was a nice one.
That was a very good one.
Yes, shall I let him in?
Yeah, that's it.
Let him in.
Yeah, I think that someone might want to
back down.
Okay, thank you.
What's up?
Nice.
Welcome to the control room. This is where we have spent the last 3 years. See, it's not dissimilar from where you have spent your last 3 years. Slightly bigger, I mean, a little bit more comfortable, but still nonetheless, ish. More comfortable-ish. But anyway, this is where we have we've spent the last 3 years trying to run things in the game. One of the things I will say is that we met at the beginning of the game and I told you how there are no rules and how things happen that we don't necessarily expect. And I think in this room here, we really feel the effects every year. And this is the ninth year. Every year we feel exactly what that feels like. In other words, not really knowing what's going to happen. Because you guys, like every previous year, have been really brilliant in coming up with new and innovative ideas along the way. And every time you do that, it kind of steers us a particular way. Do you know what I mean? We had, say for example, I'll give you an example. We've had every year, you know, we have written at the top of that board over there, artist to die. Now, because we like to make this decision about who's going to die. But often, we nearly always kill somebody, but this year, nobody died. We did have somebody addicted to alcohol, who had an alcohol dependency situation going on, and
yes,
we can determine.
Yasin
died, yeah, but I'm
but
talking about
killed.
He wasn't killed in the way that
we wanted
him to die, you know. That's what I meant to say.
He was accidental.
See, anybody watching this video now will get very concerned. Yeah. There's one thing that hopefully people go away from Hammelburg with, and that's with a new sense of confidence in their ability to be able to make a change, not to their own, only to their own working situations, but also to the working situations of others in the music industry. Just say one thing, we have seen, and I didn't say this earlier on, we have seen people really change through this process, and that's been a real joy to see, you know what I mean? And we want those people that have changed positively to remain changed. As they are, you know, and I think, you know, that's a real strength. Hopefully, if you do, you know, if you do believe that that's happened, then, you know, remain strong in that sense. So party this evening,
yes.
Please, last little word, party responsibly, please.
Yes.
Party responsibly.
It's easy jamming, just playing with the lads and playing with the band has just been really brilliant.
great. It's just honestly neat and straight up. It's probably been like the last couple of days have been probably some of the best days of my life musically. Just like jamming and just exploring, and we all kind of gel. We all seemed to gel very quickly. Within an hour, we had a real groove down. Like, you know, we were grooving it out really well. You know, so it's just been absolutely brilliant experience.
Yeah, so much fun playing with these other guys as well.
Yeah, no, it's awesome. Like, really.
Yeah. And you know, we're working with these guys from Belgium, and these guys they kind of get straight away what you want, why it's so easy working with them.
Genius. He's a genius.
Good, yeah.
He's incredible. Rodrigo. If you see this Rodrigo, pick a genius. No, he is. He's incredible. Like, I couldn't do what he does.
No, he starts with the purest thing of playing music. Just get together in a room and then, yeah, just start with a little detailed thing and just find the groove and find the band. And that was an amazing experience for me.
My name is Udo Daun. I'm the director of the Pop Academy. I'm sure everybody's looking forward to what's going on this stage later on. Now we want to hear some music. I think this will be a great night tonight. Do you agree? Do you agree? Yes, so let's look for that.